And in the case of the Yallourn coal measures, mm-hmm. you know, they've got dates on it, on the coal. And when you go to this chart, you can see that they were deposited as the waters of Noah's flood were going down. And so the waters had come up on the earth. They had inundated the whole of Australia. And so there's a lot of features about Australia which are strong evidence of the flood covering the continent. And then as the oceans sank down, so you get the Southern Ocean, Pacific Ocean, Indian Ocean, as they sank down, as the floodwaters had reached their peak, the waters then started to run off the continents. And that's what's okay. happening with these coal measures. They were running off the continent and they were filling up this big area at the edge of the continent, which we call the Gippsland Basin. Mm-hmm. And they washed off a lot of vegetation. There'd been a lot of vegetation which had been ripped up during the flood of the pre-flood world. And this vegetation was being washed down, and as it was sort of grounding, you know, settling out, there was more sediment being washed over it. And so that's how you get the Yallourn coal measures and these other deposits within that area.
Okay, so the floodwaters come up, but then as they start to come back down, water goes to the lowest point. The vegetation, because it's a mess of vegetation everywhere, is going to start to go into those
areas.
Places.
That's right. And then it gets covered with other. But it's a very interesting situation. Mm. So, and that's how the Yallourn coal measures that we talked about, how the mainstream geologists interpret it. It doesn't work very well, but they're not happy to go anywhere else. And yet when you start from a biblical perspective of the global flood and where it fits within that, it makes a lot of sense.
So, Tas, this is big because you're saying, as opposed to a mainstream geologist that would talk about coal forming in swamps slowly and gradually over millions of years, you are presenting evidence that the coal isn't millions of years old and, in fact, can't be because there are features in it that don't need millions of years and can form quite quickly and can prove that this didn't take a long time. This is a big call.
It's a big call. That's right. And so people need to look at it and people need to do their own personal research into it. And so I guess that leads to, you know, the significance of it, doesn't it? As to one of the questions is why do geologists persist with that, with this swamp interpretation, swamp story, I like to call it a narrative, this swamp narrative. You know, the media provides narratives for events mm-hmm. that happen to paint it in a certain way. Mm-hmm. So this is a narrative which paints it in a certain way. Why do they persist with that? And I think it's a worldview belief system. It's not really about evidence. It's not about sort of nuts and bolts and rocks and that sort of thing. It's to do with big questions of life about where did I come from? Why am I here? And what's my purpose? You know, am I responsible to anybody? Did somebody make me? I don't like that idea. And I'd prefer to think of the idea that I'm my own person. I make my own decisions. I do my own thing. So there's this. So even as we've been talking about it, and as people have been following us through on this video, I think that will be different. People will have different sorts of reactions. I know from previous occasions there's been some quite violent, very upset, angry reactions at what I've said.
Where does that come from?
And people say, you know, this guy's an ignorant. I don't know if he learned anything in college or anything like that. You know, and that is a typical reaction of somebody, in a way, who's got this emotional response. And I think it's a good thing for somebody to reflect on, why did I get so upset about that? What is it about me? What is it about inside of me that's making me react so violently?
Mm. And you'd encourage that person to actually ask that question.
Exactly
right. Notice what's going on.
Exactly right. And often that can start somebody on an amazing journey of discovery.
We've got an amazing resource. Can you tell me about it?
What is available is a documentary. And what people probably thinking. You're probably thinking it'd be nice to have something which deals with a list of topics, not just one. We dealt with geology here, but you might have biology, astronomy, and different things like that. So, and also you might have questions, some of which haven't been raised. You know, there's a niggling there and you're sort of not prepared to embrace yet, but you would like more information. So this downloadable documentary would be ideal to be able to answer those questions. It's called Evolution's Achilles Heels.
And this documentary is available for a free 7-day stream. The link will be in the description below. Evolution's Achilles Heel.